What I loved about the Deutsche Bank story is at the Milken conference, apparently this was like all the conversation. What's Deutsche Bank going to do?
I love this story too. Yeah, it really is one of these pieces that kind of takes you inside the thinking because, you know, in all the talk about the numbers and, you know, you guys were talking about the overseas cash with Apple. We spend so much time talking about numbers, but one of the cliches, and it's true on Wall Street, is, you know, the biggest assets are the people, and the people at Deutsche Bank are very, very worried right now. But Wall Street is also about opportunism, right? And so people at other banks are thinking like, huh, who do I like over at Deutsche Bank?
Everyone has to have like a list in their drawer. If you don't, I don't know what you're talking about.
Absolutely. But, it's pretty amazing.
But the thing that strikes me, Jason, is this is of a piece, in my view, with the way they handled their transition to the CEO in this sense. I mean, it's easy to second guess from the outside, but news gets out there and they let it dangle and they let it go and they don't do anything and it makes it worse and worse and worse. The way you do this is you decide what you're going to do first and then you announce it. You don't let it all leak out and then say, oh, what should we do about laying people off? Who's going to stay? Who's going to go?
I'm really glad you brought that up, David, because I had lunch yesterday with a Wall Street guy who's very senior in sort of the comms world. And he was musing about that very topic and this notion that, and also the sort of have and have nots, both from an actual business side and from a communications and messaging side about between the European banks and the U.S. banks. And this has been a process, as you say, that has been, to say the least, a bit clumsily handled here.